Oh my god, Lumpy Sir Jams, I'm so sorry about that hanging on the pre-stream bit there. I was jamming to the music. I'm really sorry. I decided to put the credits music of Super Mario 64 on, and I got too into it. And then I forgot I had to press the fucking buttons on the stream deck to start the stream. So you guys were just stuck on a black screen for a while. Sorry about that. But then Mario 64 soundtrack is a lot more important than a stream. Wouldn't you agree? Anyway, how are we all doing today? Can we get a triangular fossa in the chat? Don't ever mention triangular fossas to me again. I'm gonna have enough of a pain with that on the next video. But hey, we're here. How are we doing? It's-a me, Martin. And this is his first 3D outing. My Patreon supporters were very, very lovely and kind and voted on what I should stream next. And they all said Super Mario 64. I'm playing the Switch version on the All-Star. Siri, I'm not talking to you. That's why did Siri started listening to me as soon as I said, it's a me, Martin? What? Why? Why are you listening to me saying, it's a me, Mario? Is that a Siri bug? Does Siri know who Mario is? Does Siri think that... I don't know. Rathman, thanks for the $1.18 donation. Well, we all know how first streams go, so good luck from the little landlord. Thank you. And Sirianol 321 subbed. Thank you. But hey, should we make a start? I think we should make a start. What do you guys think? Kekisan is beard. Hello, Caddy. Thank you for the resub. And Colorblind Rage, thanks for the resub. Oh, look, it's a him.
Hello.
Hi. How you doing, Martin? Oh, I see. That's why this costs a lot of money on the Switch version, because they had to change that graphic down there to say press plus and not press start. Oh no, I wanted to fuck around with his face. No. Can we go back? We can't, can we? You actually can't. You have to start. Oh my god, are you kidding? No, quitting. I'm restarting. No, we have to play with his face. One simply does not start playing Mario 64 and not stretch his nose out so that he looks like... Yeah, you don't start Mario 64 without making his nose look like a long wang. That is just gaming lore.
It's me, Mario.
It's unwritten, but it's important.
Hello.
Also, is this too loud or too quiet? I'm not really sure, to be honest. What do you guys think? Is it too loud or too quiet? Audio is good. Ah, hey Ryan, how you doing? Thank you. Just right, a bit quiet. Quiet? Stream volume is perfect. Just fine. Quiet. Okay, I'll turn it up the tiniest bit. I can't have it too loud, guys, because otherwise you won't be able to hear me. Okay, right, so how do we screw around with his face? Okay, we can twist his face with the right stick. So how do we, oh! Ah! How do we do- Why did that happen? Oh! Oh, that's headache. That's a headache right there. That's his head, and it's aching right now. I didn't know that was a thing. Oh, that is horrifying. Oh my god. It's like a million, like, badly drawn birds are all sitting on some weird kind of fleshy- Ah! No. I don't like this. No, I don't want to do that. How do I play with this? I just want to play with his face. That's all I want to do. Why is this not working? Oh, B. Okay, you press B. Alright, okay. So, okay, stop moving. Okay. Now here's the nose, and there's the wang. There we go. Now I'm a happy camper. Are you sure you can't pull it as much as you used to? I mean, look, we've turned his ear into a loaf of bread, so that's fun. I think this is the limit you could stretch in the... This is the limit you could stretch on the original, I'm pretty sure. What happens if you... Wait. Let go. Ugh. Okay, wait, can we make him talk? Oh god, he's Wallace! Cheese, Grommy! Can I get his cheeks? No, that's his ear. Can I get that cheek? Oh, what a cutie.
Oh, there's a young whippersnapper. Do you want one of my boiled sweets from 1903?
Okay, anyway, let's carry on. We're not going to get anywhere if we're not careful. Anyway, thank you, Bleeding Fish, for $2.69. Found your channel about 6 months ago, and boy, I love it. Being a PS1 kid, it's a nostalgia-filled fun ride. Thanks for being awesome. My pocket changes my payback. Thank you. Alice of Wonderland, thanks for 300 bits. Here for some bits with a person who always cheers me up. Thank you. And then we've had a sub from Mr. Gutterman and Shiniest Meat Unicycle resubbed. Thank you. Anyway, so, I'm sure you're all wondering...
Dear Mario, please come to the castle. I have baked a cake for you. Yours truly, Princess Toadstool. Peach.
I'm sure you're all wondering, what does she mean by cake? Now, I've got a theory about this. I actually think she just has a cake. No, I don't think there's any innuendo or insinuation there, because if we know anything by Mario game standards, Mario ain't getting none of it. And so when she promises cake, the fat fuck probably thinks there's actually cake waiting for him, and that's why he's rushing over to the castle. He doesn't want Peach, and Peach doesn't want him. It's a strictly food-based relationship. It's not healthy, it's toxic. He needs to get out of it. But the most important thing is that he can still move around quite fast. Oh wow, this text is all like not pixelated. This is weird. B to jump and Y to attack. Ah, see, they use some of the budget to change the letters in the text. A to read signs, L stick to move Aria around, and now head for the castle. Ah, this is nice. Okay, so we're just gonna get the hang of the game's controls again. Sorry, honey? Yeah, I don't understand Mario's ass in this game. Do you think it's a pocket? I don't know if it's a pocket or a boil. I'm not really sure, to be honest. Has he got worms? I mean, what is going on in Mario's butt? I mean, I don't know, but it's very... I mean, maybe it's a cushion. I mean, maybe it is a cushion. So we got the long jump. We got the... Yeah, that's fine. We can climb the trees. On the outside of the tree, apparently, because that's how N64 games were. Alright, I think we're good with the controls. I know everybody... We're not good with the controls. I'm going to fail very miserably. Yes, by the way, this is going to be a 100% series of streams. My history with this game is quite weird. So I've actually 100%ed this game once before. I really, really loved it when I did that. It gets tricky in places, but I really loved my time doing that. And I've actually only done it on the DS version. And I've only done it one time on the DS version. Which is the harder version anyway, based on the controls and the fact that there's like 30 extra power stars to get. So it should be a relatively comfortable ride going for 100% this time. I am going to say it now, because then it makes for perfect comedic timing when I fuck it all up. Good afternoon. The Lakito brothers here, reporting live from outside the Princess's Castle. Mario has just arrived on the scene and will be filming the action live as he enters the castle and pursues the missing power stars. Yes, that's why I'm here. Not cake. As seasoned cameramen, we'll be shooting from the recommended angle, but you can change that with the R stick. Well, your recommended camera angle is terrible. I'm just going to say that now. Your camera's not very good, Lakitu. If we can't adjust the view any further, we'll buzz. No, if you can't adjust the view any further, you're shit. That's what's going on. To take a look at the surroundings, stop and tilt it forward. B to resume play, switch camera modes with the R button, blah-de-blah-de-blah. Reporting live, this has been the Lakito brothers. Well, the game isn't called Super Lakito 64, it's Super Martin 64. So, let's just carry on with the game. Thank you, Spartan Gamer, for a $19 donation, thank you. Hey Caddy, congrats on finishing Crash 4. I was stuck on Cortex Castle and you mastered it, plus the final boss, I salute you. Good luck on Mario, keep being cool from Joanna. Thank you, very kind. But anyway, yeah, so this text box isn't from the Lakitu. It's actually from Bowser, who I think is King Koopa in this game. I don't think he's called Bowser in this game. But I can understand the confusion that, like, you've just been speaking to Lakitu with that text box, and then you walk into the castle, and all of a sudden, the same text box appears, and it's telling you to get the hell out of the castle. So, I'm sure that must have confused a few kids at some point in the 90s, but there you go. Well, I mean, Bowser doesn't want to be an ungracious host. He wants to welcome you in, but he also wants you to piss off. He wants that cake. And when I say cake, I mean princess's ass. Am I glad to see you? The princess and I, and, well, everybody, we're all trapped inside the castle walls. I like how he's like, and the princess and I, are having an affair. We're trapped inside the castle's walls. Oh, he is called Bowser. I thought he was King Koopa in this. Using their power to create his own world in the paintings and walls. Please recover the power stars. Yeah, do you know what? You're still annoying even when you're not making any noise. I'm sorry. Okay, let's go to the first door on the left. Anyway, we've got a sub from Liam Langan. Thank you so much. Oh, 500 bits from Analog Brayan. Sorry for missing that. I wish I could watch your stream, but I'm at work. So here's some bitties and good luck. Thank you. And we've got Ivers with a resub, thank you. Shiniest Meat Unicycle, 200 bits, thanks very much. Carter Bale, thank you for the resub for 2 months. And another resub from 09 Havocworm. This is the first game I ever played. Ah, good place to start, good place to start. See, my household was very, my household was PlayStation, basically. Because I don't know how many people know. I know how to do this game. Fuck off. I know how to do it. I know how to do it. Don't patronize me. What is it? A kids game? I don't know how many people out there know. But the UK wasn't very, at least as far as I'm aware, and from based on my research, wasn't very Nintendo lovey. It was pretty Nintendo hatey, actually. If I have to say. Oh god! Oh god! Ah! Chain! Charlie Chain! No! Stop! Oh, I'm doing so good. I'm doing so good right now. Lakitu Bros, what the fuck are you doing? Come on. No, run, 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 run! I'm trying to save you. Why are you eating me? Oh my god! Why am I struggling so much? Okay, he's free. He's happy. No, he's not. He's the same face he was 5 seconds ago. I like how his happy face is the same as I'm gonna eat your soul face. There we go. First power star. Wasn't even the one we were supposed to get, but that's how this game goes. Here we go. 119 to go. Who's ready? Behind the chain chomps gate. But yeah, so sorry. My, I'm pretty sure that the UK was very, like, lacking with Nintendo, and I don't know if it's because of the price or the advertising, but as I just don't remember anything Nintendo being advertised ever until the GameCube. I don't remember seeing any Nintendo 64 things in game shops. I don't remember seeing them in magazines. But then again, like I said, it probably was the more expensive option at the time, and I just don't think it kicked off, because I do know for a fact that Sega was massive in the UK. The Mega Drive or the Genesis was ridiculously huge in this country, and I think everyone was just looking up to maybe the Saturn, or potentially looking, because of the Saturn being CD based, they then looked at the PlayStation, which was a logical jump forward, and it had a CD player, and we had our 90s music booming scene and everything. So I don't know, I think there was definitely a correlation between Sony and Sega and the UK, and Nintendo were just never as big in this country as they were in America or Japan. And because of that, I didn't see this game until I was about 8 years old, and I remember. Oh, this is a secret, isn't it? Yeah. I saw this game for the first time when I was about 8 or so, and it was one of my dad's friend's sons who had it on the N64, and I was used to like jaggedy models and everything on not even Crash, but like Tomb Raider and stuff like that. That was what I was used to seeing on my games. I was not used to seeing, like, I know it's primitive, but these like smooth sharp shapes that were all like clumped together, you know, because the N64 does have a very, very unique style to it. Oh god. Oh god. We just had to. We just need to bum him, don't we? That's it, yeah. We just pick him up and bum him, and then he'll die. That's how this game goes, right? But I just remember going over to this person's house. Maybe my mum was doing their hair because she was a professional hairdresser at the time. And maybe, oh god. Yeah, but whatever the case, I remember seeing this guy playing it on the TV, and he was on Womp's Fortress, and I remember being blown the hell away by how the game looked. And I wanted a Nintendo 64 and that game right then and there, and it never happened. I never had a Nintendo 64 until I was about 16, when I then got one on eBay. And then, yeah. But then, playing Mario 64 in this country, you don't do it. You do not do it. Oh dear.
That's how we do it, boy, garden.
Yeah, bye. I didn't think that's what a bomb would sound like if you killed it. I thought there'd be more of an explosion, to be honest, but there you go. But yeah, like, it's pretty crazy either way, but like, if you want to play this game, even if you lived in this country and you had a Nintendo 64 and you had Super Mario 64, you would have had an utterly miserable time.
That's how we do
yes, you would have
garden.
Done. And I, well, okay, honey, but it's because you didn't know any better. And I say, I mean that with the utmost respect. There's a reason I say that, because PAL games on the PS1 and Nintendo 64 and Sega Saturn and Mega Drive, all that shit, it was all done in 50 hertz and not 60 hertz. Our TVs didn't... Wait. Well, I was wondering why he wasn't running. That was going to be an easy race. I pressed the wrong button. Go. Right. And so, because of that, our games essentially ran 20% slower than every the Japanese games and the American games. If something run at 60 FPS, for us, it may have run at 50. If you had something running at, like, I don't know, 30, it would run at 25 for us. And this was one of those situations where I don't know if this is how it ran in America. I don't know how, if this port is how this game used to run when it first came out, but in the UK, it doesn't run like this. The frame rate is terrible, and Mario, not even kidding, moves like half the speed he's moving now. It's unplayable in this country. So I was very happy when this little pack came out. Does the shortcut work even in the race? Oh, Koopa the Quick hasn't even got a chance. More like Koopa the Gullible. There we go. But yeah, it's not right. You do not play Mario 64 at like 25% of the speed and like 25% of the frame rate. It's practically unplayable. If you didn't know any better at the time, then obviously it was great and it didn't matter, but obviously now we know, and you just can't go back to it. So I've got a physical copy of Mario 64, and I had the Nintendo 64. I converted it all, and yeah, you took your sweet ass time. Jesus Christ, what were you doing? Thanks. Where's that been? That came from out in between your legs. I don't want it. But yeah, you just don't play it. Because I managed to, like, convert my analog signal through an upscaler, and I was ready to stream all of my Nintendo 64 collection. Like, I've even got Conker's Bad Fur Day, which is a rare game in this country. I've got all that shit ready to go. But Jesus Christ, playing Nintendo 64 games, I can handle PS1 games. I can handle that. But I cannot handle Nintendo 64 games in this country. They run so slowly. So, what mission did I click on? I'm too busy rambling. Teleweb Cartoons, thanks for the resub. And Takumo, thanks for $5. Nintendo got screwed when The Sun, who else, published a front page headline, Nintendo killed my son in 1993 after a 14-year-old died of an epileptic seizure, which was blamed after only a few minutes of Nintendo gameplay. They clearly didn't play Parappa the Rapper or, like, LSD Dream Emulator or any other... Or, like, any of the Sega Saturn things. There were loads of games like that. What are they talking about? How about, like... Yeah, I don't know. But hey, thank you, Demonic Box, for 200 bits. Hey, what's up, Caddy? How's the Crash 4 grind going so far? It ain't fun. Zaf the Nerd, for the thank you for the sub. 200 bits and one-shop animation. Thank you, Ben, for that. Do us a favor, look up the controls with the minus button and look what they called his drop move. I will. Ah, and Shearsh is back. Thank you so much for 300 bits. Hello from UPS Customs. You have a whole group over here watching an old favorite. Thank you. Oh, and I knew you, Shagirl, I think that says. Thank you for the sub. Sorry, what do they call his butt bash? Crouch. Kick. Suspend. I thought it said suspend Mario. Oh, it's in actions. Sorry. Pound the ground. Oh. It's like American pie, but instead of a pie, it's the floor. American ground. There you go. That's nice. Oh, we've got breaststroke as well, which is the worst name for anything that anyone's ever come up with. By the way, what are we doing? I was too busy rambling and I forgot what... Can we pause the... Shoot to the island in the sky. Ah, that said that we need to talk to these guys to open up the cannons, right? Well, talk to me then. We're peace-loving bombers, so we don't use cannons. Well, thanks. That doesn't help me in the slightest. Oh, no, he's going to open it for us. So we're peace-loving, so we ain't going to do it. But if you want to blast someone up, someone's head off, you go ahead, dude. We're going to enable it. We're pacifists, but we're enablers. Those are the pink bombs. Okay, right. Let's go to the floating island. Can we make this? I don't know. I'm gonna go there. Oh. Well, that wasn't even vaguely close. Boy garden. Hey, Charlie. Or Charles, whatever we called you. Thank you to Scepter Jams for the sub and Admiral for the resub. Oh, what time is it? It's 20 past 10. Unfortunately as well, this may be a short stream, guys, because we've had a bit of a problem in this household. We haven't had consistent hot water for 2 months, and our landlord is dreadful. And I'm saying that on stream now because, honestly, at this point, I couldn't give a fuck. So, he doesn't even know what I do. I've tried to tell him. I tried to force him. Like, aren't you interested in my face? Watch it now! And then he told me to go away. So I can say this on stream and he'll never see it, so I don't care. Wait, where am I going? Yeah, I know the floating island, but where's the cannon? Oh, wait, I know where the cannon is. I've got to fire into the wall. Wait a minute. There we go. But yeah, so we've had a bit of a problem with hot water. We're finally getting a new boiler installed tomorrow, but it's getting installed at 8 in the morning. Like, 8 in the morning, it's being installed. It's not, oh, wake up at 8 and we'll see what the time is, and then we'll get here between 1 and 5. No, they are coming at 8 in the morning, and I'm not looking forward to it. So, yeah, I'm going to have to cut the stream off a bit early just so I can get some sleep. Oh,
that's
Noah's
in my garden.
Noah Sanctum, thanks for the sub, and Joey's Game Safe, thanks for the sub, very kind. Okay, right, I'm gonna take this really gently. Aim at the tree, and then I'll grab the tree. Oh, didn't need to. I skimmed my face along the edge. Oh God, this camera. Come on, thank you. Start. Yeah, there it is. There's the bugger with the beady eyes. Here we go. Hello, children. It's me, Mario. Oh, God. 4 stars out of 5. And when I get 5 stars, I've got a perfect score and I can quit. Oh, night-night, you. Oh, Amy's repping the merch. Amy's repping the merchandise right now. She's got her nightie on, which is a logo shirt. Anyway, find the eight red coins. Excuse me? Joey's Game Safe, did you just gift 50 fucking subs? Holy shit! 50! 50! That's older than my mum! No, is it? How old's my mum? Guys, my mother, how old is she? I forgot! Holy shit, thank you! I'm gonna turn off the alerts though, because holy shit, you are not gonna be happy with my voice, but... oh, Foxcat, thanks for the sub. Oh, and thanks for the resub, Trondalav. You're going to see those names pop up in about 5 minutes after all these other subs have done their bit. But anyway, I don't think we can get find the Ed Rate coins. I don't think we can get this one because I think we need the wing cap. But my memory's pretty fuzzy, as you guys know. I won't say hello to the landlord, no. I don't want to be liable. If he then gets upset with me, I then want to be able to say, no, I was talking about my other landlord. My landlord from my old house. Maybe I could try getting the 100... Oh, no, maybe the 100 coins are only for getting the wing cap as well. I'm not sure. Let's try it. Let's see what we can do. Oh, I fell on the floor. That's what I can do. Yeah, forgot about the backwards somersault. The backwards sandwich. Okay, right. Okay, can we climb up this slope? Yes, we can. Hang on. I don't remember the physics being like this in the slightest. Wait, when did Mario... I thought, okay, you come to this ledge, honey. If I run off it, what do you think will happen? You just fall off, right? No, not in Mario 64 land. I thought we were playing Mario 64, not Galaxy. Yeah, I can't climb over a fence, and I can't go up this bloody stupid green turd here. Look, doesn't work. Oh, it did! Oh, no, it doesn't. But yeah, I can go right up and over. Oh, even the Goombas can do it. If a Goomba can do something, it probably sucks. Okay, right. I'm gonna try the 100 coins. It might be a massive waste of time, but... God, that camera is fighting against me. It really is fighting against me. Oh, no, the subs are still being counted. Sorry, everybody. In my ear, I'm just hearing me doing a farmer's voice over and over again, so it's not exactly fun. Oh, this guy's got a special shell, hasn't he? There we go. Sweet. Oh, there's a fight. Oh, that's annoying. Oh, so I would have got 5 coins each for getting the... Oh, balls to it. Okay, I tell you what is strange, is playing Mario 64 with vibration. I'm not used to this at all. This is very weird. This is like, it's vibrating as I wow, okay, I fell into the wall. Okay, so in a second, I'm going to hear a new alert in my ear, and that's when I know the alerts are over, and then I'll start catching up with them. So I need to go up here. I got the red coin there. Over the seesaw bridge. Also, I'm just going to come out and say it. This game looks better than the DS version. I think that, yeah, obviously the models are a lot better, but I just, there's something about the N64 crispness and the sharp, angular, aggressive shapes. It looks like a load of building blocks. It's a unique look. It's like PS1 3D Jaggy kind of look. I love that kind of aesthetic. I don't think there's any shame in that, and I do think this looks better than the DS version. The DS version has aged worse, in my personal opinion, because this looks cleaner, where the DS version looks really muddy. Okay, right. So opens the gate. Oh, we can get some coins from these guys. Do you know what? I think I fucked up the whole coin situation. I'm just going to carry on. I wonder if there's a quicker way we can get... Oh, we can use the cannons, but it's more fun to run, to be honest. Hey, there we go. New alert. Colorblind Rage, thanks for the $5 donation.
That's how we do it in my garden.
Oh god, there's another sub. Thank you, Remy the Yoshi, for the sub. Very kind.
Phew.
Anyway, thank you for the $5 donation, Colorblind Rage. This is my first time tipping. Thank you so much for making me your first. I know everyone says they hate their first, but I hope I was alright. I started watching you about 2 years ago. My first video was the banned PS1 game. Oh, good. That's not a bad place to start. I'm happy about that. After I finished, I called you the British JonTron. I've been called that lots of times. Anyways, thanks for the last and great commentary. Good luck on Mario. Thank you. Yeah, that's how I basically identified myself. I didn't deliberately identify myself as that, but people did that for me back in, like, 2012. And that's how I picked up an initial audience and got in with Normal Boots and even got friendly with John for a time and then just kind of... stop talking. But yeah. Oh, Dingolo, thanks for the $6.47 donation. Can you sing the Postman Pat theme like that one bloke from the cringe video? Oh my god, not the hand over his mouth guy.
That's how we do it in my garden.
No, because not enough people know that reference. Hey, I got it. Oh. Oh, Jesus Christ. Oh, Bling Guy, thanks for the sub. Very kind. I like how sometimes you just get an influx of new supporters and new, like, tips and new subs when it, what depending on what game you play. I find it fascinating. Way. Oh, clean jump over that ball. There we go. Ugh, okay, right. I know this game has aged. I mean, it obviously has aged, but god damn it still plays really well. For how old it is. It plays way better than, like, Crash 1. Anything in here? No, that's just the, okay. I don't think there's anything else I can do here. I'll go over to the floating island and see if I can grab any more coins, but there's one on the top of that tree. Oh, God, you know what? See, I've never even thought about this as a design idea, right? So... the draw distance on these coins here is terrible, because I guess there's more of them. But because the red coins are, are collectibles, they made sure that they were really, really visible. That's really smart. Like, the draw distance on the red coins is massive, while the draw distance on these, look at them, they're terrible. Oh, the two red coins are down there. See? Look. That is so clever for the limitations. Holy shit, how could you hate this game? It's so fucking good. It's so good. It's so damn good, dude. This is when I'm gonna regret saying that, isn't it? Okay, I need the win cap for this, I know, but I'm just playing for the laugh. Okay. Can I butt slap? No, okay, no butt slap for Mario today. Got 61 coins. Nah, that's probably not enough, is it? Yep, just get rid of you, because I have to do that. Well, I don't, but, you know, ignore me. Thank you, Gaming Gala, for the sub. 5 stars. Made a good start. Made a good dent so far. Have I played any of the Half-Life games? No. I played, like, half of 2, and I really enjoyed what I played, but I got to a point where I was like, everyone was telling me at the time it was the best fucking game ever made, and I was like, really? It's good, but what? And then I went back to Bioshock and just completely forgot about it. So I know that's probably a sin on my gamers, hashtag gamers, my alpha gamer bro card. Oh, we can't do this yet. Okay, let's quit. Nah, we need to get out of here. Get out of here, Mario, before they take you. What happened to Pup Icarus? Oh, well, Pup Icarus is currently in my bedroom, collecting dust and wishing that he never went on my channel. That's what he's doing. Okay, I think there's another door, actually, with no star count on it. Oh, no, 1 star count. I'll do them in star count order. So this one, I think, is one of the water levels? No, this is Womp's Fortress. Oh, I thought that was a 3-star one. Okay. Trepidanos, thanks for the gifted sub. Very kind of you. Now this one is one I'm pretty sure. Yeah, I know I can tilt the stick. Right, I'm pretty sure in this one I can get 100 coins if I try, so I'm gonna give it a shot. Like, can you just imagine back in the day, like, you have this new Nintendo console, everything's in 3D, which is already a mindfuck, and then all of a sudden you have an analog stick, and the more you push it, the faster Mario runs in any direction. It must have been the most mind-blowing thing ever made. Right. And the funny thing is that, like, when there's a few times in videos I've mentioned how much I love Mario 64, and loads of people will then immediately jump to me saying I've got nostalgia goggles on, or like, what a, like, oh, it's it, like, yeah, you it's just because you were a kid and you played it all the time and you can't look past its faults. I know it's flawed, but I've got no nostalgia for this game whatsoever. I first played it on the DS, and it was when Vine was a thing. I think I played it for the first time when I was, like, in 2015. Not even kidding. And that was the DS version, and I loved it even on the DS version. So it's like, no, I actually just don't agree at all. I've got no nostalgia for this game in the slightest. I just think it's great. And I can see why people gasm over it all the time. Okay, is there something on top of this thwomp? Like, look at the models of these thwomps. You can't tell me this isn't the greatest game of all time. Look at them. They look like... What do they look like? They look like fucking, like... What? What? They look like washing machines. Like, what? Oh, I don't know. Thank you, 9RJP6, for the resub. How's your day and how's Super Mario 64 going? I'm enjoying it very muchly, and my day's going fine, thank you. How is yours going? Okay, and you know what? I'm gonna get... No! That was a really bad idea. Okay, right. Okay, backward Samusolt. That didn't work. Backward Samusolt? Oh, no, night, you. Have a nice sleep. There we go. Right, there's some coins down here as well, pretty sure. Yeah, the draw distance is terrible on the coins. Like, I was basically 5 feet away from them before they decided to show up. But whatever. Okay. Yeah, this is going all right. Okay, now, what... Ooh. Ooh. I get nervous when I see these platforms. I say ooh when I see them. Okay, right. Now, the question is, where are the blue coins going to pop up? Because I've only got one shot. Okay, they're behind me. Oh, that was it. Oh, okay. There was only four. That was anticlimactic. I thought something else was going to happen.
Oh,
but,
yeah.
Well, okay. No, no, I'm not complaining. Makes things easier for me. Okay, right. Awesome. Right, let's carry on. Okay, so we've got the dangerous route and the safer route that falls down. So let's take this route. Oh, no! No, 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 no! Okay, that was a bad idea. Okay, I'm going to take that. I'm going to take the dangerous route. Ah, okay, right. Okay. No! Martin, I don't know what you did there, but I love you. You can have my cake anytime. Oh, he touched me. Okay, fall back asleep, fall back asleep. I was never here. Thank you. Right, let's try that again. There we go. Okay, right. Okay. Run across here, the big wooden spoon. Let the wooden spoon turn around. And then let us just pick up the rest of the coins without moving. There we go. Oh, no, no, not worth it. They want you to follow it so that you go down this ramp and fall off the edge of the stage. That's what they want you to do. Okay, come on. Okay, right. But four more coins to get and then we're done. So there's a star down here, isn't there? And I can't remember how to get that. Oh! I had absolutely no idea that was a secret. Did you know that was a secret? I didn't know. Still learning things about this game 30 years later. When did it come out? 1996? More or less 30 years. Let's just say it's 30 years, even though it definitely isn't. I'm not going to bother doing my math because I'm playing Mario 64. I've got no time for learning. Okay, right. Wait. Right. This should get me the 100 coin star. Yeah. Easy peasy. And I think we can still keep going.
Here we go.
Oh, thank God, yes. Okay, good, good, good. Right, I didn't want that to be for nothing. Okay, right. Okay, so I'm gonna actually, because I've already collected some red coins, I might actually try and go for the rest of the red coins. It's a risky shot, but I'm gonna try taking it. And yes, I have tried this before. You can long jump onto that arrow. You can. Except not then. It's possible, but not by me, basically.
Oh, dear.
Oh, I said Mamma Mia and oh, dear at the same time. Oh, shit. No, you can do it. I have done it before. I did it on the DS version because I didn't realize you could knock down one of those things. But you can do it. You can. In fact, you know what? Fuck it. Let's try doing it. Might take me all night, but I feel like I need to prove a point. Because you can do it. I know you can. Oh. Oh, the physics haven't aged very well, I'll say that much. Okay, right, let's try that again. Red coin number one. Boing, boing, boing. Oh. Boing, 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 plop. We fell.
Mamma mia.
Yeah, mamma mia to you too. Right, let's try again. I am going to get these fucking red coins. Maybe... No. Because if I've got to climb, I was going to say maybe I should get the harder ones first so that the easier ones are easier to get. But actually, that makes things more complicated, doesn't it? Okay, so then we go up these steps. Okay, cool. And then we backward somersault onto this guy. There we go. And then we... take care of you, buddy boy. Actually, no, let's not take care of you. Actually, maybe we should take care of you. Nah, it's all right. Okay, right. There we go. Then we go across here. No! Can I jump on these guys? I've never tried, actually. Let's try it. No, I don't know if you can, but... No, I have no idea, and I'm not about to find out. Ugh. Okay. Coin, red, blood, coin, death. No, I missed it. Damn it. Okay, right. Okay, here we go. No, no. Martin, come on. Come on, Martin. I know you're a bit lardy, but I know you can jump. I know you're acrobatic. Okay, right. I'm gonna fucking do this if it kills me. I swear. I swear to God. Okay. Just gotta aim properly. Oh, I hit it. I touched it. I touched it. No, I can do it. I can do it. I'm gonna do it. I am going to do it. I just need to adjust. When the camera changes, I just need to remember to snap the analog stick in the opposite direction. And then I'm good. I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna do it. Blocks have eyes, and they kill Mario by pushing him into the abyss. Okay, right. Let's go this way. Oh. Oh, I slid off his head. I didn't know you could do that. Yes. Two. Then we go... Boom for three. Then we go Shazam for four. I'm gonna take care of you because you're just getting in the way. There we go. Then we jump on the wooden spoon. I'm gonna try and get the life this time. Let's go. Go. Oh, damn it. I missed it again. I'm gonna get this. I swear to Christ I'm gonna get this. If God is my witness. I will believe in Jesus if I don't get this. I swear. I swear. Okay, right. Let's try this again. As soon as the camera angle changes, push the stick in the direction that it is. No. This is a tricky one, guys. This is a tricky one. Let's go. Do you know what? I'm not ready to start believing in Jesus, so I'm gonna do this. I hope you don't mind, guys. Oh! Oh God, that was close. I should probably go. Oh no, I shouldn't go the other way because I need to grab the red coins, don't I? Okay, then we go this way, then I jump over him, and then I go this way. I'm gonna get this. I swear to God I'm gonna get this. No, well, not that. I wasn't talking about that. I was talking about the thing up here. The gap that we shall call Jesus Cliff. Jesus Gorge. This is Jesus Gorge. Oh, okay. I'm not even getting there at the moment. Okay. Do you know what? I'm gonna take a lucky shot in the dark here. Oh, come on! I was so fucking close! I was so close! I know I'm giving myself a self-imposed challenge, but at this point it's the principle. I need to do this. I need to do this. Let's go. Have I still got the 100 coins? Yeah, I do. Okay, I was gonna say, like, I don't know if it actually saved because I died. No! Oh my God. Okay, right, let's go. Yeah, that's a slightly quicker way. Okay, go. Okay. again. And again. Jump over your mate. No! Okay, right. I don't need the game's stupid handouts. I don't need the wooden plank that gives me a bridge that takes me straight to it. Oh. Oh, there's a red coin there! Oh! Damn it, damn it, damn it! No! No, I missed the life as well! Okay, well, I didn't know there was a red coin there, so that helps me out quite a lot. I nearly grabbed it a second ago. I should be able to do this. Okay. And let's try one more time. Maybe I just need to go up as straight as I possibly can. Okay, right. Got ya. Okay, right. Off we go. Let's get the remaining two red coins on the stupid bloody Jesus Island. Right, let's go. And yes, I am doing this because I'm stubborn. There's no other reason. I gave myself a self-imposed challenge. Somebody in the chat said, it's not possible. And I was like, yeah, it is possible. I've done it before. And now I've got to prove that it is possible. And that I did do it. Otherwise, you're going to think I'm a dirty little cheater that lies about my Mario 64 EP. Okay, right. What? Okay, right. I'm going to set the camera angle in such a way where it won't then screw me over the second I make the jump. So I'm gonna put it... Wait. Okay, so I'm too far to the right. Okay, right. I think this is a good place. I think. Here we go. Why did the camera angle change? Why did it change?
Mamma mia!
It is possible. It is possible. I'm not going insane. It is. Do you know what? I'm just going to go for it first. I'm going to go right up there first thing. And if I can't do it, then balls.
That's how we do it in my garden.
Thank you, Sleepy Screen. I love you, Caddy. You're amazing. Thank you. That's very kind of you. That's very kind. Sorry, there's just a load of emotes there, and I can't read what they are from my end of the screen. Can I do a seat? Swit! Yeah, there we go. It's a shortcut. Mm-hmm. Okay, right. Right. So if I jump off here... Low Poly Mario! Oh, I forgot about Low Poly Mario! Oh my god, he's adorable. Okay, right. I'm going to move the camera this way. And then I'm just going to take a leap of faith. I'm going to get it! This goes beyond proving a point now, game. This goes beyond that. This is a matter of life and death now. Doesn't matter if I game over. I don't care. I want to do this. I'm going to do it. And every single time I fail, I'm going to find quicker and more unique ways of getting to the top. Like falling off. That's one way of doing it. Okay, let's not do that way then. Let's go back again and try. Let's go up the slope with the yellow arrows on it for some reason. I don't know why they're there, to be completely honest. I figured it's pretty obvious that we're heading up, but you know... This is a kid's game, after all. Oh, okay, I'm gonna just wait now. I don't want to take that risk again. Okay, go. Yep. We are speeding along, my friends. Off to Jesus Gorge. Here we go. Where, if you don't believe, you'll believe in him after you're done with this. Okay, right. But then the next question is, can I get the rest of the red coins without dying? That's the next point that we need to try and figure out. Okay, right. So it seems to me that I keep on overshooting it too much toward the screen. So I'm going to actually aim really offside to the right. I'm going to aim really off-center. Gotcha.
Good.
Fucking did it. Told you you don't need it. I told you. Okay, now I can't move the camera anymore. Oh, take it slow. Take it slow. Knowing my luck, that's where the fucking star pops up, isn't it? I bet you £1 million that is where the star pops up. Wait, what? The red coin there? Oh, it's on top of the... Oh, okay, right. Okay, do you know what? It's actually easier to get there. Okay, I should have done that the entire fucking... I should have done that 20 minutes ago. Oh, Martin. Martin, you cheeky little skank. What was that for? Okay, right. So we've got the red coin here. At least if the red coin... Okay, it's all right. We've got a fence here. It's fine. It's fine. If the red coin pops up on that platform, at least I know how to get to it. Okay, right. Okay. All right, Martin. Slow down. Ooh, Marty boy. Where's Alex and Glow? No! Do you know what? Something happens, guys. Whenever you mention anything to do with Madagascar, you fail. I don't know if you've ever tried that before, but it's very true. But now I know I can get to that other side, no problem. I can get to that other floating island with no issue at all. So I'm actually just going to do that. So I'm going to get these, and I'm confident in myself that I can get the rest by taking the other route and not the... No! There we go. No! No, okay, thank you. Whoa. Woof. That's all I can say. Woof. Woof, Martin. Okay. Oh. I was doing well and then I fell. Oh, everyone in the road heard. Oh, I got the life! Yes! I'm not going to game over! I thought I was going to game over trying to do this, so I'm glad at least I didn't need to do that. And the best thing is that because I've proven my point, I don't need to believe in Jesus now. So that was the thing I was... Yeah, I said to everybody that I would start believing in Jesus if I couldn't do what I was trying to do. But I've done it, so it's okay. There we go. 10 times easier. Why the hell didn't I do that before? Okay, 7, and then the 8th one is down here. Yeah, thanks, Mario. You weren't falling, but it's okay. I get that you're scared of heights. It's fine. Can I get it? Sweet! Fucking done it. Oh, it's over there. Okay. All right, well then, that was probably the most time-efficient way of doing it. That's the closest one to the star. So, fucking go me.
DJ! DJ! DJ!
I know, I wish you could hear it too. Yeah, so do I. That would... the fart I sometimes use. Anyway, shall we actually play the game now? I've wasted so much fucking time. So much time just to prove a point. Because I'm a stubborn old donkey. Oh, hang on. Okay, so that's slidey. I'm trying... Should I take a risk here? No. No, I'm not taking a risk. I've done enough risk-taking for a lifetime. Oh, the piranha plant upstairs. We called it, what did we call the... Pookie! That's what we called him, yeah. Hello, Womp. I've come to chip you off.
It makes me so bad. We built your houses, your cars, and we paid your builders till you walk on over us.
Well, can I ask a philosophical question then? What are you walking on right now?
Mom. I'm walking all over my cousin. Because it's legal here. It's not incest, I promise.
Right, okay. Come on then. Flatten yourself on your cousin. Come on. Let's see if they like it.
Oh,
yeah. I don't know if they like it. No, you gotta try another area. Try over here. Try over here, dude. Maybe your cousin likes it here. No, no. very stressful music for a kid's game.
No! Just a girl. I'm just a stepping stone after all. I want gravel. Gravel. Here you go.
Thank you. Oh, he's gone. He did the same thing that the King Bob-omb did. Here we go, indeed, Martin. Well done.
Good.
Well done. We got another star. Considering that I spent about 15 minutes trying to prove a stupid, ridiculously childish point, we've got 8 stars so far. We're doing all right. Hasn't even been an hour yet. Or has it been an hour? I don't know. To the top of the fortress. Not to be confused with the fort, which is the male version. Sorry? 55 minutes it took me to get 8 stars. Yeah, I'm not going to be at GDQ anytime soon. Let's just say that. Maybe I could be at GDQ for longest time to prove a point. Maybe I should... Do you know what? Maybe I should start a new charity event where people just try and make bold, ridiculous claims about games and then spend the whole time streaming trying to prove their points. I'd watch that. And I invented it. Unless it already exists. I mean, fuck. Alright, okay. So this is basically the same as Chip Off Womp's fock, but now we're going to the top of his cock. So this is what happens when you kill a thwomp. Oh no, not a thwomp. What are they? Womps. A womp. When you kill a womp, they plant themselves into the ground, and then they sprout, and then this is what happens. So he buried himself, and this is what this... He did. He germinated. He did a nice bit of photosynthesis, and he came out on top with a nice little red tip. So there you go. There's a star. And that was your lesson in womp reproduction, ladies and gentlemen. Mario 64, a game for all the family. Okay, let's go back. Shoot into the wild poo. Let's go. Shoot into the wild blue. Shoot into the wild blue. That's the mission. Shoot into the wild blue. We're going to shoot into the blue. Pretty wild in blue. Very wild. It's blue. And we shoot into it. Sorry. Thank you for preparing the cannon. Very kind of you. Your big, lovely, fluorescent pink cannon. Okay. So this is where we got to aim at the pipe, I think. Yeah, like there's a... Oh no, I'll aim at the wall. I'll aim at the pillar so that I bounce off the pillar and I don't go any further. I'm gonna aim there. Damn. Oh, it's underneath. Oh, I thought it was... Oh, okay. Thank you, Tear of Grace, for the 172 raid. You're being way too nice to me, Tear of Grace. In fact, you almost make me shed a tear of my own grace because I'm so happy about that. Thank you, dude. Very kind of you. Hope you're doing well. Skull Knight, thanks for the sub. What happens if I fire myself here? Oh! Forehead attack! That's what happens. Everybody in the chat, you know what to do. If you're a subscriber to my channel, spam the chat with caddy-only emotes and make everybody wish they never got raided by Tear of Grace. So aim a little bit lower and then maybe we'll make it. No, we just hit the corner. Okay, I need to take the hard way. Okay, that's fine. I would aim for the top, but I don't think that really gets us anywhere. Okay, so if I aim a little bit higher than last time, aim for the pillar, go. Sweet, done it. Okay, right, so then we climb our way down. Everybody, Super Martin 64 is now going to do some pole dancing. No, he's not. He missed it, but he got the star, so it's fine.
Good.
He got the star. That's all that matters. Ah, oh, look at that chat go. You make my VODs look very interesting as well, because you just put loads and loads of funny pictures in the, I've got 10 stars, everybody. Once we got 12, we're 100... Once we got 12, we're 10% done. Fall onto the caged island. Yes. Mario 64. Mario goes to Alcatraz. Oh, this is when you need the owl, isn't it? This is where you gotta shake the owl out the tree. There he is. Who's there? Who woke me up?
It's still daylight, I should be sleeping! Hey, as long as I'm awake, why don't I take a soft play with me? Press and hold B to grab onto my P. Release B to let go. I'll take you wherever you want as long as my wings hold out. Watch my shadow and grab onto the only bits that are hanging down.
Okay, where are you? Where are you? Come on, where are you? There you are. Oh, sorry, I have to hold it. Yeah, I forgot. I was too busy doing stupid voices. Yeah! I'm Martin! Yeah! Okay, so this is where I just gotta guess where the hell... Oh, I thought you have to control the owl. I forgot. So we need to find the caged island. There it is. Okay, I'm just guessing. Depth perception is pretty terrible. There we go. You're kidding me. Martin, lose some weight, for fuck's sake. You were in there until you clipped the edge. So where does the owl go then? Does he come back here? Does he go back to the tree? Oh, he's there. Okay, right. There's a bird called a house Martin. Ah, oh, so now Martin is a bird. He is a house Martin. Okay, right, let's try that again. Oh dear, oh dear, oh dear. No, 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 no. Okay, we've kind of gone briefly tank control-y for a second. Okay, right. And drop. There we go. Easy peasy. Easy peasy, lemon squeezy. Take it easy. You're so sleazy. Oh, Eon the Grape, thanks for the sub. Are you actually a grape? I don't believe you. Mm-hmm. I did not know. Now, people like to say that this particular star, aside from the hint of the star is blast away the wall. So that's the hint. And this is very hidden. I won't deny this is very hidden, but I don't think it's bullshit because I think this is the only canon in this stage, I think. I could be completely wrong though. Maybe I'm completely wrong. But if you know that blast away the wall is the hint, then you know you've got to be in the canon. And then as soon as you look around, you can see there is a little bit of a crack in the wall there. See that? So there's no other area. It could, like, over there is one star. There's nothing over here. You could fire yourself on this and you won't die. So you can trial and error that if you really want to. You can like brute force your way through puzzle solutions. Gutter Wizard, thanks for the sub. And Trepidanus, thanks for 300 bits. Enjoyed the shenanigans and getting some clips there, but I gotta head out. Have a wonderful and Martin-tastic time. Thank you, very kind. But yeah, so there's like this one here. So this one should immediately make you think, okay, what else can I blast away? There isn't anything here. So let's blast away this corner. Boom, nothing there. Oh shit, well maybe there's another corner. Let's try that one then. So then logically you move on to the next one. And then that is where you find the star. Look at that. Although if you're nearly dead, you will kill yourself. So that's not fun. I'm gonna just pick up some health before I do this because otherwise I'm going to embarrass myself. Yeah, I'm just gonna Martin it right up. Digimanda, thanks for 200 bits. I hope your playthrough is going well. It is, thank you. Even if there's bits that are difficult, I just can't stay angry at this game. It's just so jolly. I think I said in one of my videos, maybe the Bowsette video I did ages ago, I think I said that, like, if there's any game that will heal your cold, dead heart, it's this one. Perfect shot.
Good.
Ah, good stuff, good stuff. And again, I can say that with no nostalgia goggles, no nostalgic bias, no childhood experience with this game, I just think it's great. I'm afraid this isn't the original N64, although it does look like it. This is the Switch edition. Oh, we've done everything. Oh, whoops. Yeah, we've got all the stars. Oh, cool. We've 100%ed Womp's Fortress. That didn't take very long at all, especially with my stupid bullshitting. Womp's dress. Okay, right. Okay, this is where we unlock the wing cap, isn't it? Yeah, okay. Let's try it. Welcome to the wing cap course. Step on the red switch at the top of the tower in the center of the rainbow ring. Okay. When you trigger the switch, all of the red blocks you find will become solid. There we go. ZL, yeah, that's fine, dude. Right. Oh, whoops. Yeah, big red nose there. We stepped on the big red nose. Wearing the wing cap, you can soar through the sky. Well, soar is soar isn't the word I'd use to describe it. I'd say you dollop through the sky, but you know, it's close enough. I would like to say thank you, game. Okay, right, so hit this, and we get the wing cap. Yep, start music again. Right, now I think we've screwed this up already, haven't we? Because we need to be able to, yeah, we screwed this up already. We need to be able to start, like, straight away. So maybe we have to just quit. Okay, get out of the level. Quit. Yeah, exit course. And then we go back in, and then we immediately start nice and high. And we can try and get the rest. Okay, right. Right. Sorry, guys, I'm going to concentrate. I've already failed. I failed on coin one. Okay. Maybe I haven't. Maybe I can pull this off. Maybe I can pull this off. I might be able to pull this off. Okay, I'm going to shut up. I'm going to keep quiet. I forgot about the time limit. Fuck. I nearly had that. I nearly had it. Do you lose a life when you do that? Thank you, Colorblind Rage, for 300 bits. Very kind. Okay, let's try that again. I nearly had it. I nearly goddamn had it.
That's how we do it in my garden.
Thank you, Non-Surveyum, for the sub, I think that says. Thank you. Okay. Oof. Okay. Just take it as slow as we possibly can. Okay, back we go. I don't want to risk dying every single time, so... It's not impossible, it's just a little bit awkward. I don't mind these bits too much. It's just a little bit awkward. Okay. Let's try again. The tip is to basically keep your trajectory slightly pointed up so that you don't constantly pick up speed and momentum. But then you need to go a little quick, otherwise you're going to run out of time. It's a delicate balance. See, now I'm going too fast. Yeah, I'm going too fast. Yep. Oh, dear. Now, I do remember trying to do this on the DS version was an absolute nightmare, I can tell you that much. Thank you, Jim Man Squid, for the subscription. Great name. Love it. Okay. 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 Yeah. Slow it down a bit. Slow it down. Slow it down. Yeah. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Did it. Oh, okay, didn't take me as many times as I thought it would take, so I'm happy with that. That's fine. Whoa! Slow down, horse. Okay, right. Perfect. Awesome.
Good.
Here we go!
That was good. That was good. The DS version annoys the hell out of me because it's the superior game if you take it from design and visuals, I guess. The problem is it was released on the wrong system. If it was released on the 3DS, it would have been the definitive perfect way to play the game. Like Star Fox 64 3DS, it would have been the absolute way to play it. Yeah, it would have been portable, but it would have been the way to play it. It would have been so good. And I'm so pissed off that they were so desperate to show everybody, look, the DS can do 3D. It's like, yeah, but Resident Evil DS existed and... You could have done another Mario 3D game, you know? Mario Kart DS was great, you know? So it's like, I don't know, just seemed a bit forced to me. Right, 13 stars, so we're past the 10% point for 100% completion. Oh, and it is important to note as well that I did play the DS version on my 3DS backwards compatibility, so the circle pad helped a little bit, but the point is the game's controls are built around pressing buttons on a D-pad, so you've only got 8 directions, very heavy turning, it's not instantaneous like on the analog stick on the classic one, so it's not a fun time either way, you know. Okay, wait. Snow Mountain Summit. Watch for the slippery conditions. Okay, I'm gonna try getting the red coins, actually. If that's a good idea, I'm not honestly sure. I'll go this way. Okay, wait. I'm gonna get all the coins. You watch. Yeah. Okay, right. So this is where. Oh, maybe I'm gonna grab a star either way, aren't I? Wait, I might not be able to control this. There we go. Ah, nearly a perfect coin run there. Okay, right. Now there's a secret tunnel in there, and that's good to know for the race. At least I can get the 100 coin star relatively easily, I suppose. Yeah, I'm gonna ignore the star at the end of here. I'm just gonna grab the 100 coin star while I can. Oh, maybe you don't get a star. Maybe you actually got to do it in a certain time. Oof, I don't know. Oh no, you do. Okay, fair enough. Right, red coin, just to up my coin total. Ignore that star. I'll get it when I can. That's what you sound like. Red coin there. Slow it down, Mario. It's slippy here. There we go. And then we get this one here. And then we move our way back to the top of the course. Thank you for the $5 non-servium, I think that says. Just wanted to stop by and show you some love. Ooh, sorry. Discovered you a while ago. I'm going through the complete seasons at the moment. I'm having a blast. Thank you. Cheers from, Shekia, does that say? Thank you so much. I didn't know I'd have people that enjoyed my stuff that far out. That's crazy. Thank you. Oh, we got an enemy there. We can hit the enemy. Also, I think I'm one of the few people that really likes Mario's 1-2 kick combo. I think it's a good emergency if someone's coming right up to you and you won't be able to do it. Like, it's a good tight attack in close quarters. It's not very good in general, but in a specific situation, it is really good. Oh, shit, I missed all those coins. Oh, fuck. Oh, fuck. Oh, fuck. No, no. We can make it. 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 We can't make it. No, okay. Mario's sliding down backwards. Oh, shit. Here we go. Okay. Well, I say sliding. He's kind of hovering. Yeah.
That's how we do it in my garden.
Oh, God, no. The star's gonna be... No, it's gonna materialize along here if I'm not careful. Okay, just slow down. Slow the hell down. Okay, right. Jump, 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 jump. Got it. Woo! That was close. Kaida 92, thank you.
Good.
For the subscription. I do want to say thank you. I also, it boggles the mind to me as well how they did this snow effect. Because they, obviously they're not 3D objects, they're sprites. But it's just the fact, maybe it's the same thing, the kind of thing that Doom did. But it's like, it's amazing how it's spatial to, because I thought that the limitations would only allow them maybe to put the effect on overlay on the screen. But it actually, it's spatially aware of itself. It's really clever shit. Oh, another life, great. I lost all of them trying to prove a point, and I've lost that one too, haven't I? Don't you get an extra life for getting 100 coins? I swear to God you do. Maybe they've took that out. Okay. So I don't think I can get the red coins because I need to be able to activate the, Oh shit, I thought you were jumping my way. Oh, I was trying to do a dive! Oh, fuck off. Okay, right. Well, I'll do this either way. 6? Maybe I could get the red coin star. I don't know, maybe. Where are the other two? Maybe you need, Yeah, I think you need the elevator to grab the, other red coin, don't you? Oh, God. I don't... Oh, I don't like this. Not sure. Not sure. Okay, so we need you to activate the cannon for us. Okay, there's a red coin. So where the hell is the last one? Is it on that island? Anywhere here, maybe? Oh, I think that's another star there, or maybe it's a life. Oh, Jesus, Mario, slow down! Not sure where this final coin is. Oh my god, ice physics! Ice physics on the snow is not fun. Oh, bollocks to it. Okay, run. There we go, done it. Ooh, okay. I like how walking off the edge, like Tomb Raider, walking off the edge kind of... Well, no, walking off the edge in Tomb Raider doesn't do anything. It stops you from falling off the edge, but I do like how, in this game, it puts you into an automatic hang. Okay, I'm gonna grab these red... I'm gonna go back to the top and see if there was something I'm missing. Because that little slope area is suspicious to me. That one with the, exclamation mark box. Okay, Oh god. Okay, right. I wonder how we get there. Oh, okay. No. Just take it easy. Take it easy. Oh, it's there! Oh, sweet. Is this another life then, or is it a star? Oh, it's a knife. Okay, cool. Can I grab it? Yes. Awesome. All the red coins got. Great. Where's that? Is that around the corner? Gonna slow the fuck down. Oh, it's there. I just saw it for like a split second. There it is. Right, okay. So I need to make my way down safely. And then get over to that broken bridge and do a very, very, very specific and very tricky triple jump. And I should make it. Thank you, Chronicron, for 200 bits. Thank you so much. Ow. I can never get past those snowmen without taking at least one hit. Maybe a long jump will do it. But I don't want to risk it. Oh, no. That was a bad run-up. Okay, let's try that again. Okay, no, that didn't work. Maybe I'll try a long jump. Maybe I'll, like, clip onto the edge of the thing and then... Wait, what? Oh, God, don't kill me, for fuck's sake. Are you kidding me? I can't jump on them? What? Oh, that's dookie game. Come on. What the fuck? Extreme Blue Moore, thanks for the sub. Damn! Oh, right, let's get the red coins all over again. Fuck's sake. Okay, so there was one there. I don't think there was one on the slide. There's not one here. I just got that life as well. Balls to you. A pox on your family. Jesus Christ. Okay, slow. Boing. No, slow. Boing. Then slow it down again. Maybe I can get another life. Maybe it's just infinite retries. Oh, great. Awesome. Well, I had the red star. I had all the red coins. I found all 8. I headed for the, where the star popped up. And I was nearly there. I failed the jump, so I went back up to try it again. And then I was killed by a snowman, because you can't jump on the snowmen. Which I didn't realise. I thought you could jump on the snowman, but no, apparently you can't. I'm going to try and get this other life here as well. Thank you, Kid Vermin, for 200 bits. Super Mario 64 was the first console game I ever played. Very lucky. It took me 20 years. But I finally finished it last week. Wow, it took you a while. Super cool to see you play it, man. Hope you're enjoying it. Oh yeah, I love this game. Yeah, this isn't a case of, oh, I've never played this game before, or, like, that's why I didn't tag this. I had to untag blind playthrough from the last few streams I've done, because I've been using it for my last few streams, because I have been going in blind. But this is one I do know a little bit. Not a lot, but I do know a little bit. I know the beginning way more than the end, but I think that's the same with most people. Okay, can I do it? Oh, wow, that was the first time I've ever goddamn done that. Holy shit. I'm going to try a long jump here. Wait a minute. Oh, okay. So the long jump makes it. It looks like a higher jump than it actually is. All right, okay. Right. From here, it looks like... Yeah, it looks really high up. I thought a triple jump would be the only way to do it, but apparently not. There we go. Get out of the snow. You can piss right off. I'm not doing anything with you ever again, snowman. I am not taking you to the ball, and you cannot convince me otherwise. You have been a very, very naughty man. Okay, six. One there, and then there's one here, right? Okay, take it slowly. It's very easy to forget there's ice physics on the snow. It's backwards, because usually the snow is a little bit more stable than ice in games, but yeah, this game has ice physics on the snow. I don't think it's as bad as the ice, but there is still a slippiness to it. Okay, right. I am going to go back. And then I'm going to take the elevator up, or the lift, whatever the fuck you want to call it. And then I'll try that long jump again, and then if I'm lucky, I got all the fucking coins, and then we're good. Not many things in a game can make me as nervous as this goddamn thing here. This rickety-ass wooden plank on a string. Not many other things can make me as nervous as that. Okay, right. Under! No, he's gonna turn around, isn't he? Oh no, I could have done it again! Oh, second time in a row! Holy shit! Bingo.
Good.
We got a star. 15! Doing well. I didn't expect to get 15 stars this... Well, I could have done it quicker if I wasn't such a bloody bitch in Womp's Fortress about getting the red coins. But this is what you guys watch my streams for. Slip, slide, and away. Alright, best get all these sliding ones out of the way then. Right, I'm gonna familiarize myself with where the shortcut is, just so I know I can jump straight in. That was a perfect coin jump there. Nice. Nice. Okay. Oh, got a life as well. Got a life. Oh, there's another life. What? Mario, what the hell? Mario, stop! Mario! Mario's rockabye babying to hell! Mario, stop! What was that? I didn't touch anything! He just did it! Whoa, what the hell was that? Rockabye baby on the treetop, when the wind blows, Mario bloody dies. Okay, right, grab the star. Oh, that was crazy. Oh, this is course four. Oh, damn, I was supposed to try and do them in course order. Whoa. Mario's bum freaks me the fuck out. Yeah, same here. Freaks me out too. I don't know why it's so rotund. He is a thick boy, isn't he? They should call it Super Mario 64. Everybody has permission to unsubscribe from my Twitch channel, and maybe even my YouTube channel for saying that. Okay. Got the baby penguin. The pengling, as Benedict Cumberbatch would call it. The funny thing about these penglings... And we need to take this baby back to the mother penguin. If no one knows what I'm talking about, look it up. Just type in penguin on YouTube, and you will quickly soon see what the meme is. It's pretty funny. Okay, right. Right, this is where getting past these guys is basically impossible unless I throw the penguin. Okay, no, we gotta wait for them to come this way, don't we? Okay. Yeah. Oh God, what's worse, this or Baby Yoshi in Super Mario World 2? Okay, so we have got two of your sons here, Mrs. Penguin. Do you want any of them, or shall I send them to the slaughterhouse? What do you want? Oi, is this yours? You found my precious, precious baby. Where have you been? How can I ever thank you, Mario? Oh, I do have this star. Here, take it with my eternal gratitude. Oh, great, I get a place on the Hollywood Walk of Fame for finding your lost child. Thank you. But you know what? Wait a minute. What happens if I grab this one and then give it to her? Because I know this one was the fake one anyway. So what happens if I grab it and then give it to her? Does she, like, tell it to get fucked or something? Oh, balls. Ah, I don't think I can get up there. Nah, I can't get up there unless I... Oh, yeah, I can. Okay, let's see what you have to say about this other one. Thank you, Heart Fire Flame Wings, for the subscription. And 500 bits from Howling Hyena. Thank you. Thanks for inspiring me to continue to get better on the drums. Oh, thank you. It's nice every so often to know that people think I'm alright at drums. Yep, get out. Yeah, okay, right. So what do you think about this baby? That's not my baby. She looks nothing like me. Her parents must be worried sick. Are penguins just terrible mothers in the Mario lore? Like, first of all, you basically said, ugh, gross to a baby penguin. Secondly, you lost your kid, and now the other one has got no mother. And you know what's even funnier? Is that soon, none of them will have any mothers. Do you know why? No. Yeah, none of them will have any mums. Do you know why? Because I'm going to fucking throw them off the end. Oh, you can't throw them? Oh, shit. You can drop them, though. This is what you get for being horrible to the other penguin. Yeah, what have you got to say about that? In fact, what do you have to say about that? She's already gone into stage one of the depression cycle. She is already in denial. What happens if I take this one? That's not my baby! Okay, fine. If it's not your baby, then I guess it belongs to the fucking floor. Let's go. No! I want to drop the baby! No! Stop it! Oh my God. All I keep doing is pissing her off by saying that's not her baby. Like... Okay, move out the way. Move out the way. She's not going to move, is she? Every time I pick up this baby, she's going to start complaining at it. What's worse for the baby? Death or being constantly compared to another child? You're not good enough to be my child. I think death would be better in this situation. It'd be preferable. Yeah, we can't do it. So we killed your son and you still cannot help yourself but bitch and complain to another penguin's child. Oh, no, we can't do it. I've tried. Let's just grab the star and get out of here. Oh, fucking hell.
That's how we do it in my garden.
Thank you, Cyan Games, for the resub. Honestly, I've been loving your longer videos. They give a humorous side to a humorous end to a long day at work. Keep it up. Thank you. Also,
good.
We got a star. We have to say good because we got a star. Oh. Oh, Scotland Yard would like to know my flat address. Well, they're not going to get very far with that because I don't live in a flat. So I can give you a flat address if you really want. Right, so, okay, right. Let's go in here. And let's race the penguin with my stupid, bitchy, really cheap-ass shortcut. You ain't going to beat me. You ain't going to beat me. Even if you start first because you're cheating little shit. Oh, it doesn't have an anus. In Mario Party 2, it has an anus. Oh, I died. Yeah, that was, I deserved that. That's fine. That's fine, game. I totally deserved that.
Oh, yeah.
I deserved that. Right. Let's try this again. I'm gonna do it this time. Oh, wait, you're kidding? Don't take the shortcut, he won't give you the I didn't know that! I didn't know that. Okay, well then I'm not going to take the shortcut. Thanks, chat, for just throwing that in there. I just went in there to see who was talking, and I get told some vital game advice. Thank you. What does he say, like, oh, you're a cheating son of a bitch. I don't race with cheating sons of a bitches. Okay. Oh, you mother penguin. Come on. Yeah, I didn't know that.
Mamma mia.
I mean, I would have done that, so, I mean, you've missed out on a reaction from me, I guess, so that's your loss, I suppose, but thank you for letting me know either way. Okay, go down. Down the hole of the chimney. The best kind of hole. Oh, camera, come on, work for me, thank you. Ugh. So that turning there is a bit of a bitch, so I just need to remember about it. Oh God, no! Got ya, right. No! Yes! Oh, that was a close one. Very close. That was a good race, Pengling. That was a good one. You're a good competition. You broke my record. Unbelievable. I knew you were the coolest. Now you've proven you're the fastest. I can't award you a gold medal, but take this star instead. Yeah, it's weird, isn't it? How, like, Bowser somehow got rid of all the power stars, which is the source of the castle's power, and yet somehow some random fat penguin that looks like it's dressed up in a Star Wars outfit is, like, taking it and holding them ransom behind a race. Ever think about that? Hi, Ninja. Hey, dude. How's it going? Thank you so much for 200 bits. Been a while since I caught a stream. Finally glad to have more free time now that I actually work for Nintendo. You do? Tell me more in the Discord. Holy shit. Sorry for the humble brag, but I'm super excited about it. That's awesome. I need to know more about this, like, pronto. That's so cool, dude. What are you doing with Nintendo, anyway? Okay, so now I remember this one being an arse-ache on the DS because I don't remember how it works. I think you've got to race the snowball down without touching it, obviously. I'm going to take a big jump here. And then you kind of got to guide it, I think, towards here. I'm honestly not sure. No, that's not how you do it then. Yeah, this one I just remember being the biggest fucking cryptic pain in the ass. I really have no idea how this is done. I think it's just luck, if anything. Oh, shit. Whoop. Way up. Okie dokie. Right, oh, there's a red coin over here. That's fine. Yep, there we go, right. I'll try another thing. Maybe you don't race it. Maybe you kind of push it. Maybe you kind of guide it. Ooh, fucking hell, that was close. No. No, no, I want to get up there. Please, game, let me do this. No, let me do this. Okay, right, let's try this again. I need a good head on my shoulders. Do you know if anybody in need of a bullet? I'll follow you if you do. Yeah, I do know where to go. I do. Okay, maybe I need to go down this way. Maybe it follows your path. Let's try it. So you go down here. Maybe he follows your pathway. Yeah, that's how you do it. Okay. So you have to make a pathway with your sliding, I suppose, is the idea. That took me a lot quicker to figure out than it did on the DS version, I'll say that much. Classy one, thank you for 250 bits. Very kind. First time tuning in for a while, and the first thing I see is animal abuse. Glad to see nothing has changed. Sorry about my absence. Don't worry, I'm doing this all the time either way. Been playing too many games with the Discord crew. Yeah, I hope you guys are enjoying yourselves. I've been so fucking busy. I hope Stan is doing good and that the house no longer stinks. Kind regards to you and the family. Lots of love from me and Ree. Aw, thank you. And, Iron Ninja? Oh, you're, okay, telling us what's going on at Nintendo. 200 bits. Basically, I'm an ambassador for them, work for several stores, Walmart, Target, and Best Buy, in my area. I make sure they're stocked up on games and make sure the displays are on point. Oh, nice! Yeah, Iron Ninja, yeah. Yeah, Iron Ninja's getting his bits out of Nintendo now, yeah. Can't stop him. Cannot stop, you cannot stop the bits of Iron Ninja being infested anywhere. Now he's got them all up in the nose of Nintendo. And they love the smell of it. They love them. Okay, right. Whoa. Wall kicks will work. Where? Where will wall kicks work? What the hell are you talking about, game? Wall kicks will work. I'll get some more lives. Wait a second. There was, where the red coin star was, there was actually a, where the red coin star was, there was a blue coin switch, so maybe there's another area I don't know about. I'm gonna check there first. If not, then it's probably on that floating island. Okay, right. Let's see if this leads me anywhere. Nope, it's just two. And this just takes me back there. Must be on the floating island then. Oh, brother. Okay, right. I do like as well how you can negate fall damage by body slamming right at the last possible second. So I've got to open that cannon up from this lovely gentleman up here with his fancy, fancy and fabulous pink cannon. Now, getting onto this bit is easy. Getting off of it and back onto the rickety old plank of wood on string is another thing entirely. This bit is not fun. This bit not fun. It's really not fun. So, wait. Are you coming back down? Yeah, I was gonna say you are coming back down. Okay, right. Okay, right. There we go. And I didn't want to slide into the cannon. Yeah, that's exactly what I was trying to avoid by doing that run. Okay. Now, honey, this is where I've got to take a wild guess on the height I should fire myself. This is the hardest bit of the game right here. I think you aim just there. I think it's like, so the little triangle on the left, I think you make sure it's just below the shaded underneath of the roof above it, I think. Fingers crossed. Oh, yes. Right. And that's not even the end. Wall jumps will work, will they? God, you get this far. Imagine if you're like a kid and you've been struggling to get that one particular cannon shot for the whole game. And then you realize, oh, wait, that's not even the whole challenge. That's like one part of it. And then you fuck up here. You'd take the game back, wouldn't you? Okay, now we need to... Wall jumps are a bit different in this game, aren't they? Yeah, you can't slide down the walls and jump whenever you want. Oh, we need to do a triple jump. Okay. Yeah, there's no sliding down the walls in this game. You just kind of bump off them like that. So on just before you bump off, you then do the wall jump. Ah, but it's not... Yeah, you can't be too quick. You need to do it just the right time. Yep. Oh, fuck. Let's try again. This is very... It says wall jumps will work. Will they? Not working for me. Camera fucked up, but I did it. So I'm going to walk across this purely because of ice. There we go. I think we've 100%ed this level as well. 20 stars in. We're doing all right, guys. Oh, yes, I've got to get the... Yeah, I've got the red coins in Bob on Battlefield, haven't I? Yeah. And I've missed out on course 3, so that's weird. Okay, we'll go back to Bob on Battlefield. We'll get the 100 coin star and the red coins, if that is the one that I'm missing. And then we'll see what the time is after that. Mario wings to the sky. Maybe it was. Oh no, I already got the red coin. Sorry, I'm going nuts. Yeah, we need to get up to that island, don't we? And then we, and then we do the flying. Okay, so in which case, I'm actually going to fly myself out to this tree. Very, very nice, Mario. Well done. And I'm going to start collecting all the coins that I can. And then we are good. Nothing there. Okay, cool. Can I throw these at enemies? I've never tried this. Ah! I didn't know you could do that. Ah! Wise guy, eh? Oh. It needs to be a straight wall. Okay. Alright, game. Alright, Mr. Specific. Okay, right. Let's try that again. Awesome. Right. 3 coins here. 5 coins there. Can I blow up other ba-bombs? Okay, I don't know if there's a time limit on these guys, but I don't really want to find out. Let's see. Oh, shit, there is a time limit. I thought they'd flash red or something. Okay, alright. This is one of those levels where you have to, like, Cool Cool Mountain, you could get, like, 150 coins or so on that easy, but this is one of them where you have to scrounge for every single possible coin you can, and it's the first level. So it teaches you a valuable lesson, I suppose, for it being the first level. But because it's such a specific ask, I reckon they overdid it, because then the first 100 coin star that most players would get wouldn't even be from this level, because it is so specific and tricky to get. Oh, no, you don't get 5 okay, right. I thought you got 5 coins from all the enemies if you do that. No, got ya. Right. Camera, what are you getting stuck on? Why can't I move you to the right? Oh, fucking hell. Somehow I'm managing to grab all the coins and hit all the enemies. I don't know how that's working, but it's working, so I'm not complaining. I missed that one coin, didn't I? Yeah. These fucking physics. Okay. Alright. Okay. Okay. Alright. What happens if I bump into these guys? Nothing. Okay. Alright. Do these just last indefinitely? I thought they had a time limit on them. Oh, nice fart, Mario. Well done. Okay, right. Boom. Oh, I was doing so well. Okay. Oh, I missed. Oof. Okay, right. Now we gotta get Charlie Chomp. Oh, fuck off. Okay, right. The hand cream, yeah? Ugh. Right, so I think there's some things over here we can get. Thanks, Noxious Wolf, for the $5 donation. Got banned from a Discord I helped make some streamers... What? Got banned from a Discord I helped make from some streamers I helped get to affiliate. Then found out I got kicked from the WoW guild I helped them set up. Gonna chill here and donate to my favorite YouTuber. Best of luck on your Mario 64 run. What the fuck? That sucks. If only there was some sort of legal precedent, I'd say take those bitches to court. Fucking what? You can't kick someone. You can't get, like, a Discord group or... Okay, Discord chat is one thing, but, like, you help someone get to affiliate on partner, you basically own half of their stream, let's be honest. Sorry, I'm making light of a shit situation. This is what I do, I joke all the time. I'm sorry, that fucking sucks. Oh god, the trees are... You can go through them. But hey, thank you so much. Don't feel the need, you have to donate. That's a shit time. Don't feel like, donating to me is gonna make things any better. Focus on you, dude. Oh, there's a life. Sweet. Yeah, that fucking sucks, dude. Hope things start looking up for you a little bit. Especially the, yeah, like, imagine if there was, like, a courtroom system for, like, WoW guilds. That'd be so epic. And the only way that you could get, like, if one of you offered, like, if one of you went to court with a trial by combat, you'd then, like, have to get your highest level character in there and get the gear sorted. I think that'd be pretty cool. I'd tune into that. Well, I'd have to call in my WoW character, which I don't have, so I suppose I would have to call you in, yeah. Oh, God. They starve you for coins in this level. They really do. Can I get this one from, like, a... No, I can't. I'm not even going to try. Okay, oh, no! Damn it. Oh, Bryzy, yeah, thanks for the 200 bits. Just wanted to say I love you, Caddy. I hope you're all well. Thank you. Yeah, I hope you're well, too. Now, can these guys blow up wooden boxes? What am I talking about? They can. Something tells me there was supposed to be something in there. I don't know. Okay, right, let's try and grab this red coin again. I got it on my first go last time I slid down here. And I did it again. Sweet. Oh my god. Okay, right. Oh my god. So yeah, funny, well, not a funny little story, but just a little story in general anyway. So, am I right in thinking this is your favourite game, or is that Animal Crossing New Horizons? It was one of your firsts, yeah. No, but it's one of your tops, though. You love this game, though. So, Keris used to play this game when she was much younger, and she really loved it and everything was all jolly. And then, obviously, like, you move, like, she had her kids, and then you kind of lose things over time, and you have to sell things at car boot sales to provide for the kids and everything. And so what ended up happening, she got separated from this game, and then she heard about the 3D All-Stars pack on Switch. She has a Switch, and she was like, oh my god, I can relive my childhood! And you're struggling, aren't you? You're really struggling. I don't think it's... I've been trying to say that, first of all, it's been a long time. It's been a very long time, and I think all you'd need to do is just practice moving Mario around before you got back into the swing of how he controls. But then you also said that you weren't used to how, like, quick he was zipping around and all that. And the camera's a bit of a jank to get used to. Yeah, but then I asked how she was playing it, and she said she played it on the TV in docked mode, but she also played it with the Joy-Cons on the grip, the Joy-Con grip. And then I've suggested, if she wants to try it again, to use the Pro Controller, because the analog dead zoning kind of... Yeah, the amount of movement you got with the analog sticks is way nicer. You can be way more precise with the Pro Controller, whereas with the Joy-Cons, you're stuck with tiny little portable-esque kind of controllers, you know? So the analog sticks are ditty, and they can really, really be difficult to... move sensitively, so everything would move like 5 times faster. Trying to creep in this game with the Joy-Con controllers must not be that fun. Okay, now I remember this being very difficult. Oh, I didn't even get the wing cap! Oh, that was a massive waste of my life! Oh my god, yeah! Oh, okay, so, this was something that I think a lot of people would appreciate. So was this after Chloe was born? Or were you, in fact, did you have any kids at this point? So it was either Chloe or Chloe and Phoebe, but it wasn't Amy, was it? It was one of those two. So Keris either had one child or two, and she had to make a very, very sad decision and sell her N64 and all of her games. Yeah, she became a single parent, and she was like, well, I need to provide, don't I? So, Oh, shit. That was a mistake. Okay, wait. So she had to sell her N64 and all her games, which is really sad. But even sadder is that you had Mario Kart 64, Super Mario 64... Lilac Wars, which is Star Fox 64, GoldenEye 007, she had all Banjo-Kazooie. You had all these games, not even kidding, as she described them to me, mint condition, all manuals, all boxed, like no scuff works on the boxes or anything. But because she was at a car boot sale and she didn't understand the value of some games, how much did you sell them for? £3 to £5 each. And nowadays, a scuffed up used copy of Super Mario 64 in this country will set you back £40 to £60. And I said Mario Kart 64, yeah. So like, oh yeah, everyone in the chat is like, Mario Party 2 and 3, I think you said. Yeah, so that's pretty sad. I think that deserves a, I think that deserves a fail, so. Oh, I don't, it wasn't a fail for whoever bought them because they were getting a bargain. And you had no money and that was good for at the time, right? Okay, this is where it gets really, really bloody panickety, isn't it? Okay, right. Oh my god, I think this is where we get the rest of the coins in this stupid little bit here. Oh god, I can't see shit. And the draw distance is terrible and I can't make out where I'm going. Okay, I've got all of them, right. So just don't land there. Whatever I do, do not land there. Okay, right. Okay, 96. 98. Oh, Jesus. Okay, let's try that again. There's a load of coins at the tippy top, so I'm going to aim high for this one. And then I've got to aim again to get the... and then I've got to aim again to get the stuff. Which direction do I aim? Draw distance, help! Over there, guess. Good guess. There we go. Did it. Can I grab the star? Oh, yes, in the same jump. No way. And I just ran out of time on the hat as well. You could not have got good. Any more perfectly timed than that. Oh my god. Just a tribute. Thanks for the $1. Wait, this isn't Super Bowsette 64. We need Breeds. You can find Breeds online for free. You don't need badly polygonal Peach with tits on Super Mario 64 to get your jollies. I know, it's crazy. I know. It's easy to forget when you're into your video games that there is things other than video games that you can enjoy. Including Breets. Real Breets are great. There we go. Yeah, it was like saying goodbye to an old pal, wasn't it? Yeah. It was bittersweet, but again, you've made whoever did, like, did one person buy all of the games? Because I wouldn't be surprised. Oh, okay. Did anyone ever understand the point of these coins here? Yeah, but why? They don't do anything. There's no coin counter in here. Is it maybe in case, like, you lost a bit of health outside and then you can get your health back? I don't know. It's a bit weird. Right, so we'll make a start on this one, which I think is Jolly Roger Bay, I think? It's Dire Dire Docks or Jolly Roger Bay, I can't remember the name of it. Oh, yeah, Diddy Kong Racing as well! Oh, dear! Oh, no, wait, there's a secret here, isn't there? Oh, wow. Hello, Toad. Buster move? The Toad phased into our reality. And what does it say? Oh, they don't have the noises yet? I thought they were going to go, bah, bah. I thought they were going to make that noise. Mario! He's got a nose. Is it a nose or has he powdered it? Has he got like some sort of like foundation on? Maybe I should do a Toad voice for all these guys.
The names of the stars are also hints for finding them. They are displayed at the beginning of each course.
I'm sorry, I'm going to wake the kids up, aren't I?
You can collect the stars in any order!
Anyway, I'm gonna wake the kids up. I need to be careful. I need to be very careful. Yeah, there is a secret up here, isn't there? And there's another one on the other side. Oh, this is the... okay. No, this isn't the eel. This is finding the red coins in the underwater prison that Peach, for some reason, has.
Oh, I don't have cake? I don't have cake? Send them. to the tank?
It's her sewage system. It's either her septic tank or sewage system. Maybe it's where she keeps the hot water when she wants a royal bath and the toads have to scrub her. I mean...
Mario, I want cake. Also, I want cleaning.
This song's also great, by the way. I love this song. Sorry, music student here. It's not a song, it's a piece, because a song needs to have singing with it. That's what Yeah, it's a piece of music, yes. Yeah, that's the technical term anyway. It's a tune. You could say it's a tune. Yeah, C-H-O-O-N. Tune, tune. Okay, right. There we go. Grab it a star.
Here we go!
Awesome. I also like how Mario's fingers, when he does the peace sign, they look like two skyscrapers on his fist. Like, they look like pizza slices. But really, like deep pan pizza slices. Oh, jeez. Okay. Right, I'm gonna see what's up here. And then I'll think I'll call it a night after that. I know it's been a short stream, everybody. Oh, it's a life. Sweet. There we go. Okay, cool. So we are... Well, look, I need to get an early night, otherwise I ain't fucking waking up tomorrow. So, there we go, guys. We have done 23 stars in Mario 64 on my first session for a game I haven't played for a long time, and I'm not actually that familiar with, but we're doing all right. This is fun. This is fun. And we've 100%ed every level we've done so far. Bomber Battlefield, Wump's Fortress, Cool Cool Mountain. So it's all good, and we got 2 secret stars, so we all did okay. Also, that 101 star record on Wump's Fortress is very, very, very pissy offy, isn't it? We got 100 there, perfect round 100, 100 on Cool Cool Mountain, 101. There's always one, isn't there? 101 Dalmatians, more like 101 coat skins. Okay, right. Anyway, we need to find somebody to raid. So, oh wait, there's a... I gotta do a what star? Wait a sec. Vivid Bloodsucker. Wait, I have to do a star. Are you kidding? What? Someone said I missed a star. What? What is this star that I missed? There's another star on the slide. What, in Cool Cool Mountain? I haven't been to the slide yet, guys. I haven't done that. Don't confuse me. I'm already a mess. Don't confuse me. I haven't done that. No, I haven't done that. Yeah. I was going to say, I haven't done that yet. I thought for a second that there were, like, a hidden star in every single one that isn't mentioned in the 7 stars that you get in each world. So you, for a second, gave me a miniature heart attack. But anyway... Let's find somebody to raid. Let's raid... I'm picking between Ant Dude, who is playing Sonic Rush, and Thaf, who is just chatting, but he says that he's doing more bedtime stories with Hack 9. So I guess that's just storytelling, I guess. I'm not sure. Well, let's keep it relevant. I can't decide between the two, so let's keep it relevant. Let's move you on to Ant Dude with Sonic Rush. That sounds like a laugh, doesn't it? Let's do that. Raid. Ant Dudus. There we go. Oh god, no, not that one. No, the other one. No. Ant Dude 92. Fuck. Shit. Oh, whoops. I nearly raided the wrong ant. Oh fuck, I can cancel it. Okay, thank god. Anyway, thank you so much for joining me, everybody. I'm gonna get some sleep because I need to be up for the water heater fictor tomorrow. And I will see you all in 2 days' time for more Mario 64. Cheerio, everybody.